Welcome to Cross the Line Sports and proud partnership with Q City Metro. Right now I'm with one of the leaders of the defense, Mr. Aaron Smith. Aaron, how you doing?
I'm doing good, man. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you. Absolutely. Thank you for joining me. So, looking to bounce back after a tough loss, you know, the last home game for the seniors, it didn't go the way you guys wanted to. Like, does this feel like business as usual this week, or does it have like a lot more meaning to it knowing that this is going to be the final go-around for some of the seniors?
For me, I think it got a little more meaning, even though we ain't win. Their senior day at home, a tough loss. I feel like this being their last game, mm-hmm. that we really need to go out there and handle business. Not to treat it any different than any other game, but actually just make the game have more meaning to us. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's going to make us play harder.
Do you feel like it's pressure for you, even though you have an opportunity to come back again next year? Like I said, a lot of these guys, this is it for them. Are you putting any more added pressure to yourself, or do you just try to treat this as like business as usual for this game?
I wouldn't say it's more added pressure, but I do have that talk to myself where I'd be like, hey, I got to do better, because even I got to do better when we play. So I wouldn't say it's more added pressure, but I know that deep down, like, yeah, it's time for me to start stepping up even more for my seniors to help the team come get these close wins that we need.
I just overheard recently, you know, when Coach Howard were talking to the defensive unit, I overheard him say something about guys who still have business to take care of. What kind of message is he emphasizing going into this game, you know? Because you still, like you said, still more business to take care of, still another game on the schedule. So what kind of message is he emphasizing, you know, going into this game?
Hey, we got to keep doing what we got to keep doing what we need to do. Like, we still got one more game. We got to play hard. We got to secure the dub. We got to start the offense. Same thing. The whole message we've been getting the whole year, we got to come in and play hard, try to get the win.
How important is, as a defensive unit, how important is trust, you know, because – You have to read what's going on the offense. Guys have to, you know, play their assignment. Even if they see something where they want to break down, you still have to stay disciplined and, you know, do your assignment. How important is trust as a defensive unit overall for you guys?
Trust is a big thing, because, like, if you're supposed to spill the ball, but you're like, nah, I want to go to the ball, and you end up boxing the ball, mm-hmm. now you done cut out the fit of your next player, and then that can result in a big run or anything. So trust is a major part when you're playing defense, because one bad misfit can screw up a whole play or cause a big play or anything like that. But I feel like as the season went on, we were learning a new defense, and as time went on, we started trusting each other more and more and more and more. So we started playing together more and more and more, and resulting in bigger and better results. So I feel like this game, we just gotta trust each other even more than the week before that.
Absolutely. I remember I interviewed Coach Howard, and, you know, I talked to him about, you know, getting you guys, you know, being this is his first year being here with you guys, you know, getting everybody to buy into the system. How long did it actually take you to you kind of like start feeling comfortable in the new system that you guys were in?
Sheesh. Honestly, is that question for me or like as a
yeah,
as a
just
whole?
You.
For me, I feel like I'm gonna say it took a couple games. I ain't gonna cap. Mm-hmm. I don't really know when, but I know I didn't get it right out the flap. Mm-hmm. I want to say probably about week four, week five, probably like right before we got the conference play. I feel like I finally understood what I needed to do and where I needed to be in certain situations.
What's your mindset, you know, going in the flow of a game where sometimes, you know, the offense may start off slow and the defense has to hold up, and then there are going to be games where the offense gets off to a great start and the defense, you know, kind of gets slow and it's like a back-and-forth game. Like, what's your mindset, you know, when you have those, like, three and outs for an offense, but you still have to stay, keep your defense motivated and hold up your end to get the ball back for your offense?
My mindset is just I run on the field, I dap them boys up, I let them boys know we got y'all and that we need y'all to have us, like, just to keep them motivated, because I know it's kind of – unmotivational for them. They keep getting three and out. They ain't rolling how they want to. So I know they can kind of get a little unmotivated themselves. So to keep them motivated and let them know that, hey, mm-hmm. we're going to come out here and we're going to get this stop for y'all. Y'all going to come back down. And we always talk about a next drive, y'all going to score. Like, we always try to speak mm-hmm. it in existence.
How difficult is it, you know, in this era to kind of play defense, because, you know, you can't hit the quarterbacks, you can't drive them into the ground. Selfless defender at times, you get flagged for that. I remember I was at the Georgia Tech game, and one of the defensive players, one of your teammates, he got throughout the game for a hit, for like a target hit and stuff like that. But how difficult is it for you, you know, playing in this era of football where it's kind of like hard to, you know, when you can't hit the receivers like you know yeah. would be able to.
It is kind of hard because you always gotta like it's like when you about to get ready to take impact, you gotta have a thought like mm-hmm. like to make sure you're in the right form, you ain't lowering your head. He see you when you see him, so it is kind of difficult. But you know, I feel like at practice, you know, we practice good fundamental techniques, so that kind of helps you go along throughout the season, getting better at the mm-hmm. techniques and what you can't do and what you can't yeah. do.
I feel for you guys, you know, and I see it on TV all the time is when a receiver or whoever has the ball, you know, kind of duck their head, and it's like, what are you supposed to do in that situation yeah. when they duck and get low? It's like, it really, nothing really you can do about it. I mean, of course you want to make the play, you got to hit them, but at times like those type of situation right there put you guys in a bind. Is where
yeah.
where you can't. Is only so much that you can do. Sometimes, you know, when you guys, you know, get a stop, come over to the sideline, a lot of times, you know, I'm over there grabbing, like, shots of you guys. And you're one of the guys that have been very vocal, you know, motivating your guys and talking about what you see on the field. Have you always been that player since you got here to where you've been, like, a vocal player to where you speak up, you know, talk to the guys?
Yeah, like, when I first got here, I wasn't playing as much, though, but I always try to encourage everybody when they come out the field to let them know, hey, we still got a chance. We still in this, no matter the situation. When I started getting more into my leadership role, when guys started leaving, and then it's like, well, I've been here a little bit longer than everybody else. Once I started getting pushed into that leadership role, I tried to be a leader, not just only by speaking, but by showing through my actions. So I try to keep my head up because I know if they see me and I'm a leader and they see me with my head down, it's just they're gonna mm-hmm. be like, well, there's my leader. He giving up. Why I can't give up? So I always try to stay strong. So I feel like over the years of my years I done been here, the more and more I got comfortable into my leadership role, the more and more vocal I became.
When did you feel like you started to, you know, finally like is that something that you like embrace now, knowing that, you know, you're one of the guys who's been here a little bit longer than, of course, like the freshmen and the sophomores. And you know, like I said, the seniors are getting ready to leave. This is gonna be it for them. Is that something that you're like fully embracing as like being that vocal leader and holding guys accountable going
yeah,
forward?
Yeah, I definitely embrace the leadership role. I definitely do.
You had a Player of the Week award, Defense Player of the Week award a couple of weeks ago. How did that feel to, you know, get that kind of recognition, getting the Player of the Week?
It felt good. I ain't really paid it too much attention for real, but My family and like, you know, man, acknowledged it to me, and my teammates acknowledged it to me. So like, I definitely appreciate it, but I just feel like that was one of the weeks I felt like I should have did more though. So I ain't really had thought too much about it, mm-hmm. honestly.
Did you feel like individually, did you accomplish, you know, as the season begins to wrap up, did you feel like you accomplished some of the goals that you wanted to move going into the season?
Team wise?
Mm-hmm. And individually wise, like some goals that you potentially set for yourself.
Yeah, team wise, you know, we definitely wanted me at championship, so that was the big thing. We just wanted to win, and we didn't accomplish that goal. Individually wise, I accomplished a few goals, but I ain't accomplished the main goals that I wanted to definitely accomplish for myself.
What are you gonna miss as we wind down this interview? What are you gonna miss about some of the seniors, this group of seniors right here?
Shoot, man, it's a lot, man. You know, the lit boys leaving. Aunt leaving, you know, my QB leaving, and that's my roommate. So it's like, I'm gonna miss a lot. The main thing I'm gonna miss just being able to kick back and chill and just talk about anything. Like for hours at a time, we just chilling, just talking about anything. You know, in the room playing the game, beating Corey and Madden. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy, man. Time flies.
And as the season wraps up, how long after the season ends do you like take a break? You know, focus on class. Get all that done, you know, heal your body up, and then you finally, you know, get back to work again, you know, prepare for the next season.
So for me, it really don't take that long for me. Like, it depends on like if how banged up I am afterwards. But I usually jump back in probably like two, 3 weeks, like no longer than that, because it just don't feel right just sitting down chilling. Like, I got more work to do, you know. Somebody out there always getting better. You gotta always put that 1% in the tank each day. That's how I think about it.
Absolutely. And my final two questions, same thing that I asked Nick previously. What advice, you know, it's a lot of guys, you know, wrapping up high school football. Some are not fortunate enough to play at the next level, some are. What advice would you have to those guys that are looking to play at the collegiate level, those young athletes?
The one thing I always say is make sure you got your grades, man. Like, make sure they doing their work. make sure they're being a good kid in the classroom, you know, because that takes you farther than football. At the end of the day, it takes you way farther than football because nobody will ever get to take that education away from
you. Absolutely. And then my last and final question, what does the HBCU experience mean to you?
That's a good question. I feel like it's just the culture, you know. Being around a lot of guys, a lot of people that look like me, you know, embracing it, you know. A lot of guys don't win a lot of far places from HBCU, so I feel like it's definitely a chance. Like, you're never going without a chance making it from HBCU, and I think that's the cool part about it.
Absolutely. And this is going to be my last question. I just thought about this one as well. This is it. This is going to be it for Coach Pugh. But what has he meant for you personally, you know, as a football player and just as a man overall? Like, what is
Coach Pugh used to ride me hard, man. The years I've been here, he always been on me, man. I used to do a little certain stuff, and like, he used to just be on me. But I want to say thank you to Coach Pugh because he took a chance on me from a small town. He gave me a chance to play football here, you know. And since then, it's been history, you know. Like, over the years, we've gone closer and closer and closer and closer. But he always been on me hard, though. I can say that, though.
Absolutely. So it's been an absolute privilege, like I said, for me, you know, covering you guys, following you, and then my first year, kind of bittersweet. It's my first year, and then also it's Coach Pugh's last year. So I'm just thankful that I've been able to have this experience to, you know, follow you guys and, you know, cover you on your journey. But Aaron, thank you for your time, and good luck Saturday.
Appreciate you, man.